You might be wondering what an instant pot black bean soup is doing on my channel. I mean, this is the kind of dish that you'd probably find on a quick and easy Meals for Busy Moms channel. There is nothing tricky about this recipe at all. If you have absolutely no cooking skills, you can make it. And to make matters worse, it's healthy and vegetarian. Basically, it's a complete antithesis of everything I do on this channel. But it's an excellent soup. I mean, really, really yummy. The best description I can give you is that it's like a savory ganache, sort of yummy with a few crispy accents. And I mean, you know, we can't eat brioche and duck confit all the time now, can we? So whether you are a college student, a busy mom, a serious gourmand who's a little short of time, grab that Instant Pot and let's make a soup. If you don't have an Instant Pot or any other pressure cooker, I'll explain how to use a regular pot in the end of the video. Set your pot to sauté on normal. I think by normal they mean medium. Add 3 tablespoons of olive oil and 1 diced yellow onion, or whatever onion you've got. Add a generous pinch of salt. Cook, stirring occasionally until the onions are translucent and slightly brown. I find that I have to go between sauté normal and sauté less if things are getting too sizzly. Add a minced garlic clove and cook, stirring for a minute. Then add 2 teaspoons of Spanish smoked paprika, 1 teaspoon of ground coriander, and 1 teaspoon of cumin. And stir for a minute to toast the spices. This will smell really good now. Then add 1 pound of rinsed dry black beans. Yeah, I know, I didn't soak them, but don't worry, it will work. Add 7 cups of water and a bay leaf. You can improvise with spices all you want, but do not add anything acidic at this stage. No wine, no tomatoes, no vinegar. Acidic ingredients prevent beans from getting tender. We'll fix this lack of acidity in the end. You know me, I'd never serve a dish that wasn't seasoned. I like to add about 1 tablespoon of diamond crystal kosher salt. Reduce salt in half if using any other brand, including Morton's Kosher. Just a friendly reminder that my salt is very unsalty. Close the lid, set the valve to sealing position, press pressure cook. Make sure you are on high pressure and set the time to 30 minutes. I won't need keep warm, so I'll turn it off, but if you want to assemble the soup in the morning before work and serve it for dinner, keep warm will come in handy. When the 30 minutes are up, let the pressure drop naturally. In other words, wait for the pressure indicator to drop all by itself. Do not release the steam. It will take roughly 30 more minutes for the pressure to drop, and during this time, much more cooking will happen. I am counting on this cooking, so don't rush it by opening the pot prematurely. Test a couple of beans to make sure they are done. Remove the bay leaf. Pour about 3 cups of soup into a blender. Add 2 tablespoons of tomato paste, that's our acidity, 2 tablespoons of butter, 1 teaspoon of pomegranate molasses or balsamic vinegar, that's even more acidity, and blend starting on slow speed. Gradually crank up the speed all the way to the highest possible and blend until silky smooth. Pour the pureed soup back into the soup pot and watch the texture of the soup change from brothy to silky smooth and creamy. I added a bit of water to my blender and ran it to get out the last little bit of the puree. Don't forget to taste for salt and acidity. I think the acidity is fine, but salt needs help. There! You can serve it right away, but don't be surprised if it tastes even better the next day. Anything that can go into a taco would be lovely on top of the soup. Sour cream, guacamole, cheese, cilantro, but I really like an avocado lime cream. Here's how to make it. I have 1 big avocado here. Let's add lots of lime juice, about 1 tablespoon, salt, 1/3 cup of sour cream, 2 tablespoons of water, and blend it all up. Don't forget to taste for salt. Okay, Let's eat. Here are the toppings I have today. Avocado cream, tomatoes, red onions, cilantro, and crumbled up corn chips. Corn chips are the most important topping in my opinion. They provide a much needed crunch to the silky soup. By the way, you have a lot of flexibility with machines for this dish. Both the soup and avocado cream can be made in either a food processor or a blender. If you're using a food processor to puree the soup, don't add much liquid. Mostly use the beans and add just enough liquid to make them move easily. If you don't want to wash some machine twice, first make the avocado cream and then puree the soup in the same machine without washing. You know, because you know, you can go from light to dark, but not the other way around. Can you make this without an Instant Pot? Absolutely, but I would suggest you soak the beans overnight, and even with the soak, expect a couple of hours of simmering to get them completely tender. After you bring the beans to a boil, turn down the heat to extremely low and keep the pot uncovered. You want a very gentle simmer. Don't be surprised if you need a bit more water, since a regular pot allows the water to evaporate and the pressure cooker doesn't. You can always adjust the texture with more water in the end if your soup comes out too thick. So yeah, unfortunately, something like this does require you to keep an eye on it if you want to do it on the stovetop. As all great cooking ideas, this one was stolen. I got the idea of using a pressure cooker for unsoaked black beans from Daniel Gritzer on SeriousEats.com. I'll link to his equally awesome but somewhat different black bean soup below, and I hope you steal it from me and make the soup your own. Play around with the spices, the meats, the toppings. I'd love to see what you come up with. Here are more cooking ideas for you to check out, and if you are ever in the Boston area, maybe I'll see you in one of my classes.